Okay, now we're ready.
Fired up?
Yes, sir.
Coming at you.
Well, what kind of new employee are you if you can't get blamed for everything that goes wrong?
No, I'm just glad there's somebody new.
Isabel, you like get your feet wet?
Yeah.
Stand by. Hey, can you turn the fuel on?
Yeah, it's on.
Hot.
Okay.
But not a fan.
Perfect. Has anybody seen your ass yet?
Not yet. I guess I'll do it.
Private school with about 385 students, and what we do is we go around to the in the United States here, and we find sponsors to sponsor a child for their education for $26, I think it is now, a month, pays almost all of their tuition to parents. We do want the parents to be responsible, so we leave a portion to them.
Hey.
Okay. Yeah, a little bit.
Yeah, there we go.
I saw you moving, man.
Yeah, we're going to want to change the angle.
More?
Yeah, because the deck pitches up
a little bit, so.
It was me.
Yeah, there it comes, the sun. Another heat advisory day. Apples are ready. A little bit of sandblasting on them.
That's not bad.
This is key lime pie, jello, and key lime whipped cream. Key lime jello and whipped cream.
It's a five minute jello pie.
Do we have some more?
You want to lick that?
Oh, sure.
Ooh, there you go. I'm going to lick this.
All right, it is after 10 a.m. in the morning, and this is now SV Seeker's new official closing time for the rest of July, the month of August, and until it cools off out there, okay? Because this is like deadly out there right now. So we are inside working on the Dragon. And Ed is back to fixing my O-rings for the ROV so that we can put them on and off by hand instead of having to figure out some tool. We think it's not going to leak because we have a really bad one that doesn't leak. And so we're getting them closer to the bad one, but not that bad. So he's being our lathe operator today. And Rod just finishing up our pie, and he's going to be out and working on the wiring harness for us, finishing that up a little bit. And he cleaned off our table. God, it's so nice to have a clean table again. So we are in here with our beautiful little tiny, way back there on the back wall, AC unit. Hallelujah. Gauge stranded hookup wire.
Now, sticking the multi conductor, we can even strip off the jet because they'll have the colors already.
I like that. Now, Ed here has come up with a better way of mounting these cameras because there's just not enough room for the cameras and the plugs, everything inside of that. So, we're getting a better way of doing that because we've already done a dry assembly on it. And he designed a part, and we're printing it now on the 3D printer down there. Hopefully that one's gonna give us the ability to save a little bit of room in there. And Drew Morgan actually helped us out with this. We got a little problem we gotta figure out, but that's what's going on. And I'll show you the coolest thing, okay? This is awesome, okay? If you've watched me go through this door, you've seen me hit it with my shoulder all the time. And now the bolt comes back, and look at that, no more ramming into the door to get it to open. That's beautiful. He actually took this entire door off today while I was at work and planed off the top and the bottom because it swelled up from, you know, water leaking in on it and all the rain we've had lately. So sweet. Now I just got to learn not to slam it every time I open it and close it. YouTube, this is what you look like after 17 hours on the road. Meet Angel and Aaron, and what we've done here is we've proven that the servos can now work with the cameras, and the camera doesn't stop working. We had a problem with that before, and what we did is we added this little gadget down here, which is nothing more than one of these little gadgets here, which is kind of a voltage conditioner. Actually, that's a voltage. That's a DC to DC, never mind. Inside there is a voltage conditioner.
You don't have to work at breaking it here. I mean, come on.
Stress test.
No, no stress testing, all right?
You got enough stress.
Under enough stress, here it is. A nice shot of it.
See, we have a view of Ed.
Why? They don't break it.
And then.
That's where the flickers come from.
Servo movement.
Shine off my clothes.
Not even a flicker. Another day, another dollar. Say good morning, Jez.
Say good morning.
It's early, isn't it?
And now, a bolt into the chain. This is recommended by somebody who has no safety conscience. I like people like that. All right, go. Up. Look at that. Three times the speed.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
That comes out to drag it aboard.
You'll have to tack and then probably flip and tack on the other side to get it, you know.
Time is great.
Yeah. Meth hat house accident smell to it. Oh, come on.
No, you hit it like a girl.
Careful, she's got the hammer right next to me. Thank you. That's it. Sun's up. It's too hot. We're done for now. Maybe tonight.
Is it a bumblebee?
It's a hornet.
Jack, can you line yours up a little better?
What do I need to?
You gotta kick that wall and stuff into it. No, it's all pretty good. Now this is real doable.
And it does look dead, doesn't it?
I need to punch it out.
Just comatose. End of the day for the morning. Man, that stuff gets hot, brutal out there in the sun. But we've got three walls up. We're whittling down our welding nozzle here so the tip is closer to the end of it. Aaron and I both like them like that. We could buy them, but heck, we're just gonna remake the ones we got. And Hugh's out here breathing life back into our Honda compressor. This is a hookah for a surface-applied air compressor for scuba diving. That's success! True carburetor. Easy to do, cheap. Put a little Honda in then. And you don't even have to go to this extreme to do hookah diving anymore, because a lot of the compressors are sold with these oilless air compressors. And so all you do is you get a generator, run a compressor, and the compressor, get one that's oilless, and you've got a commercial dive rig. No filling scuba tanks, wonderful way to go.
You want another one?
Yeah, I'll get it.
I mean, it can be, you know, my wit and charming personality. And
big gap here.
What?
I see a big gap.
You see a gap?
I see a gap.
You do not.
I do too.
That is not a big gap.
You cannot talk me out of it. That was a gap.
Well done.